So we'll be changing our gears and we'll be looking at some practice programs this week. So mostly we'll not be teaching anything new in Python, but we'll be making you get familiarized with the programming environment in general, in making you write some codes and making you get used to writing long codes. Okay, so what we'll be doing is we have picked some practice programs which we'll be using time and again in our forthcoming weeks too. So we are going to introduce you people to those programs this week. And some 5 to 6 questions we'll ask, write corresponding programs for it, and then the same code will be revisited in the forthcoming weeks, and we'll show you how you can better these codes as you learn more and more of Python. So to briefly state, we'll be discussing the birthday paradox. I'm sure you remember that from your computational thinking course. Some searching in a list, which again is going to be a very, very naive and straightforward way of searching. Sorting, the very, very obvious way, and some matrix operations. You see, your course involves good deal of understanding of matrices. And here we give an introduction to how to meddle with a matrix using Python. In fact, we are not going to go into the details of it, but we'll be discussing how you can find the sum or product of two matrices. And finally, here's a tip. The reason why we are dedicating this entire week for coding is to ensure that you get used to coding. Right? Some of you are ahead, some of you are sort of behind, but don't worry, in this week, we will try to push all of you onto the same line. Meaning, people who are not very comfortable with coding will get comfortable, but you may want to follow this tip. The tip is, code the same program multiple times. We have been saying this again and again. We would like to exert more on this very line, that you may want to write a piece of code by watching how we code, and then delete it, and then redo it independently. Okay, do it multiple times and until you feel comfortable. All right, so good luck coding. Let's start off with some programming right now.